2020's Please announce a partnership with the New Michigan Media, a network of ethnic and minority media outlets around the state. Detroit2020.com will now connect our followers to stories of interest throughout the area. Joining us now live is Dr. Hayg Oshagan, the director of New Michigan Media. Thank you for joining us here tonight.
Thank you for having me.
So explain, first of all, what New Michigan Media is. We talked about this last week here, but now we can hear directly from you what this is.
Well, it's a network of ethnic media across the state, from Native American newspapers up north to the ones that we're more familiar with down in this area. There are over 140 ethnic and minority media outlets in Michigan. Most of them are newspapers, though there are a number of radio stations as well.
When we talk about ethnic media, we're talking about what ethnicities?
Well, there are almost 20 ethnicities in the state. The large ones are the Arab, Latino, Asian, Indian, you know, the ones that we're more familiar with. But there are Albanians, there are Native Americans, there are Bangladeshi, there are Pakistanis. There's a whole variety of populations that create the diversity of Michigan.
So in doing this, then, you're kind of giving a little bit larger voice to smaller communities.
That's part of the purpose. Part of the purpose is to create more visibility of minorities to the mainstream population, but it's also to create more visibility among minorities of each other. That is, often minorities live in their own silos, unaware of neighboring communities, and this is a way also of broadening that perspective.
I want to talk a little bit about, I know that you have a board of directors that were really the people driving behind this. If we could talk about the five people that really formed this.
The board is made up of five of the largest papers in the area. They're all publishers, our senior editors in the case of the Michigan Chronicle, but they are Osama Siblani of the Arab American News, Elias Gutierrez of the Latino Press, Tak Kyung Kim of the Korean Weekly, Bankole Thompson, senior editor of the Michigan Chronicle, and Arthur Horwitz of the Jewish News.
Okay, that's great. We're taking a look at some of the front pages that we're seeing right here and all of this. What I found interesting, reading on some of the facts, the circulation of the group reaches almost the same number as the Detroit News.
It does, that's true. In their weekly circulation is very large. And when you think of the fact that a home might have four people living in it, for example, the actual reach of the papers is almost 500,000 people. Just five papers are reaching almost 500,000 minorities in the state. In this number, of course, we're counting African-American minorities because the Michigan Chronicle is a paper of Detroit, for the leading paper in Detroit, serving an African-American community. But this is a vast number of people just with five. Add, you know, a few more to it, and you actually can reach quite a few people through media.
Well, we're happy to have you with us with Detroit 2020. How does that help both of us out?
Well, I think the broader question which D20 is addressing is the narrative about Detroit. That is, how do people see this region, and what do they think of Southeast Michigan? And I think there needs to change. That narrative, the way people think of this area, needs to change. It's not just the doom and gloom, the you know, the relic of a bygone industrial era, but that there's a lot of good things which happen in the area, a lot of investment, a lot of activity, and that a good deal of it happens in the minority communities as well. The partnership, I hope, will shed light on all the positives and all the good things which happen in this region, which make it a place that people want to live and should want to come to.
All right, Dr. Hayg Oshagan, thank you very much.
Thank you.
A pleasure being a partner with you on this project here, because we're all preaching to the choir here.
Thank you.
How many people know the good things going on? Again, we have a link to the New Michigan Media stories. All you have to do is go to our website at Detroit2020.com.